I'm Dr. Stream, a board certified family medicine sports medicine doctor practicing in the United States. In this video, I'm going to discuss whether cortisone injection, or also called as the steroid injections, can help tennis elbow or not. Without further ado, let's get started. So now first, let's understand tennis elbow. So there are four extensor tendons that attach around the lateral epicondyle, as you can see in this video here. So these are the extensor carpi radialis brevis, extensor digitorum, extensor digiti minimi, and extensor carpi ulnaris. So basically, these tendons, the extensor tendons, they, as I mentioned now, it attaches around the lateral epicondyle, which is actually a part of this bone called as the humerus. So these extensor tendons are involved in movements such as like wrist supination, pronation, wrist extension, so forth. So let's say when you do a wrist extension, you can feel that the extensor tendon is getting tight. So the way we kind of like diagnose a tennis elbow is that when we do a resisted wrist extension, that causes pain around this region here. The other test is called as a resisted middle finger extension test, where we try to resist the middle finger extension. So extension is basically kind of trying to bring the finger up. So when you try to resist the middle finger extension, and again, that reproduces the pain around the lateral side, basically kind of the outside of the elbow. So we just don't understand why some develop tennis elbow with repetitive movements and some don't. So the prevailing theory for the tennis elbow is that it likely occurs because of tendon overuse. So this can be caused by repetitive lifting or repetitive strain. For example, like let's say, assume that you're playing tennis and you're gripping the racket too tight, that causes repetitive strain around those extensor tendons. Or sometimes it can be due to overcompensation of these particular tendons due to the weakness in the shoulder and the scapular muscles. It is worth noting that individuals with diabetes are also at risk for developing tennis elbow. So this is because we know that the high levels of sugar can attach to the proteins in the tendon, thereby leading to inflammation and potential tendinopathies, basically inflammation of the tendons. So the tennis elbow is also called as a lateral epicondylitis. So when we say itis, it means inflammation. So basically inflammation around the extensor tendons. And this is pretty obvious because people present with acute pain and swelling. So our understanding was that basically it's due to an acute inflammation that is causing the pain. However, in the recent years, there has been a push to change this name to more tendinopathy. And the reason for that is that studies have revealed that this is a degenerative process where there's chronic inflammation surrounding the tendon as the body attempts to repair it. So when we look at histologically, so basically under the microscope, there is presence of angiogenesis, basically new blood vessel formation, that tells us that the body is trying to heal the tendon, along with there is not a proper collagen deposition. So collagen is basically a building block of a tendon. And there's also infiltration of macrophages, which is basically kind of inflammatory cells, or chronic inflammatory cells. Again, they all point towards a degenerative process of the tendon condition that is causing the pain. So cortisone, or also called as a corticosteroid, it's an anti-inflammatory medication. And then our initial thought process was that the lateral epicondylitis is due to acute inflammation. So basically, injecting a corticosteroid around the extensor tendon should help with acute inflammation and thereby resolve this condition. And in reality, it does work. So most of the studies have shown that the corticosteroid injection is probably the one injection that have a short-term benefit. So basically, you can see benefit right away. I've seen patients who come with tennis elbow, and once I give the injection, they feel better right away. But now we know that this lateral epicondylitis is not due to acute inflammation, but rather chronic inflammation or like a degenerative process of the tendon. Now the concern is that, are we making more damage by injecting cortisone? Because cortisone is an anti-inflammatory molecule, but still the cortisone can actually impair healing of the tissues. So with that said, now the concern is that, okay, are we making more damage by doing a cortisone injection? And that's why there has been numerous studies to start to look at to see if there's any long-term poor outcome after a cortisone injection. So in a study published in Lancet 2002, three treatment approaches were compared. So one was a steroid injection, the other was a physical therapy, or also called as physio, the other was a wait and see approach. So the goal was to assess the short-term and the long-term benefits of each option. So it is worth noting that the participants in the injection group received an excessive number of injections, almost 2 to 3 within a 6-week period. So this is considered as too much. So anyways, in the short term, around 3-month mark, the steroid group actually did far better. They had a significant pain relief, with almost 90% of patients experiencing improvement. In comparison, only 32% of patients in the wait and see group reported pain relief. However, at the 1-year mark, it was found that approximately 91% of those who underwent physical therapy or physio were pain-free, while around 83% in the wait and see, so basically people who didn't do anything, no physio, nothing, they experienced relief too. Surprisingly, the percentage dropped to 61% for those who received steroid injections. So these findings indicate that while steroid injections provide immediate pain relief in the short term, physical therapy and even a watchful waiting approach can yield better long-term outcomes. So my reasoning for the poor outcome of the steroid injection group could be two reasons. One, either the steroid injection group got pain relief and they started doing the work that actually caused the tennis elbow in the first place without even knowing it because their pain was gone. Or the other reason could be the fact that the steroids did impair the tendon healing. And the other biggest concern that I had was that some of these people in this group actually received like 2 to 3 steroid injections in a 6-week period. So there was also another study that showed that corticosteroid injection did not significantly change the outcome of the lateral epicondylitis when compared to physiotherapy or rehabilitation alone. So with that all said, do I inject steroid or cortisone injections for tennis elbow? And the answer is I do. There are some people who are actually looking for short-term benefits from a steroid injection, and after discussing risk and benefits, I do provide cortisone injections for tennis elbow on a case-by-case basis. But I always tell them to engage in physical therapy, also called as physio, to strengthen the wrist extensor muscles and also to focus on the supporting muscles of the shoulder, thereby reducing the overcompensation in the wrist tendons. So usually I tell them the pain relief that you feel is not because the tendon healed, it's just because the cortisone is masking the pain so that you can engage in physical therapy and get stronger. So which means that I tell people to kind of like be kind of easy on getting back to the activities that was causing the tennis elbow, because just because you had pain relief doesn't mean that you can go back to activities that actually cause the tennis elbow. Which means that again, from a physical therapy standpoint, focusing on some of the weakness of the wrist extensor muscles and slowly getting back to activity as tolerated. So it's also important to note that steroid injections for tennis elbow can potentially lead to skin discoloration and thinning of the tissues around the elbow. So additionally, there is a risk associated with the injection process due to the involvement of a needle, and that could be bleeding and infection. So thinning of the tissues on the injection site can also increase pain sensitivity over the location. So however, if you're not looking for a short-term pain relief, then I usually recommend to wait and watch and see how things go. So usually most of these cases, they get better within 6 months to 1 year, as you can see in the studies. So in the meantime, I would recommend people to engage in physical therapy, focusing on wrist extension exercises, and at the same time to focus on strengthening the scapular muscles, thereby trying to reduce the overcompensation on the wrist extensor tendons that might be causing the pain. So I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions or concerns, please post in the comment box below. If you found this video helpful, can you do me a small favor? Can you please hit the like button so that this video can reach more people? Okay, and I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.